After logging hundreds of hours teaching lessons on Zoom just in the past few months, I've decided there are really two different spots that you need to know to set up for your virtual piano lesson. So first, grab a stool, chair, or side table. The higher, the better. We want the seat or table to be at or higher than where the keyboard is, so you can set it up right next to the bench like I have here. As you can see, I'm using a laptop for this. I've helped students get set up with phones and iPads and other tablets before, but have found the laptop to really be the best. In this window, you can see what your teacher will see from their computer screen. You mainly want to get as much of the keyboard in the shot so your teacher can see the fingerings you're using and your hand position. If you can get some of your upper body in the frame, that's also great. Bonus if you can get also your head so the teacher can see if you're watching the music or your hands. Now, this is really all you need. But if your teacher is like me and want to do theory or sight reading or rhythm exercises together, you might want to set up a secondary station. We'll call this station B. All you need to do is spend a little bit of time getting to know how to put your music stand down so it lays flat. Each piano is different, so take time to see how to put yours down. If you have an upright or spinet piano, you'll just set it above the piano with the screen bent down a little bit further down, or better yet, use an iPad or other tablet device. So now you're able to read music that your teacher shares, and you can use some of the other fun features that Zoom has. Finally, make sure your computer is always fully charged before your lesson. If you think you might forget, have your setup by an outlet or have a charger or extension cord nearby. Bonus points if you have a pencil and metronome. That's it. You can go ahead and watch some of my other setup videos if you want to try to improve your audio quality, figure out if you should or should not use earphones or earbuds or Bluetooth, something, or if you want to learn how to use some of the most commonly used tools that we've been using in Zoom.